Ahoy ahoy crew, let's build Rolling Cutter Guillotine Cross. First, the skill information. Rolling Cutter deals melee physical damage, it deals 450% attack, and its damage scales with your base level. At max level, Rolling Cutter costs 5 SP, has 0.2 seconds of cast delay, and deals damage in a 7x7 area of effect. While spinning, you may also notice a counter above your head. This counts up to 10 spins, and is removed if you change cells. This includes teleporting and backsliding. These spin counters power up and enable the Cross Ripper Slasher skill. This can be helpful to take out ranged monsters up to 13 cells away after you clear the enemies around you. The property of both Rolling Cutter and Cross Ripper Slasher are based on your weapon, meaning you can use elemental converters to use different properties of attacks. Let's go over stats next. Strength increases our damage and weight limit. Agility helps us a bit with flee to dodge attacks, but is mainly used to lower our animation delay, letting us spin faster. Get enough agility to reach 187 attack speed. Vitality is important to let us tank more damage. We use a lot of leech effects, so having a high HP pool to play around with is optimal. Intelligence is not needed. Dexterity is needed in order to hit things. It also affects our attack speed by a little bit. Luck is also not needed, but we can invest extra points here for some extra hit or attack. Let's go over how much attack speed and after cast delay reduction we need in order to spam Rolling Cutter. For 7.6 spins per second, 187 attack speed, and 35% after cast delay reduction is needed. For 8 spins per second, 189 attack speed, and 40% after cast delay reduction is needed. Only go for the 8 spins per second if you're aiming at an endgame Rolling Cutter build, as it's not worth investing into if you're going to swap builds later anyways. On to the gears. For our headgear, we will use a Rideward hat. This gives us a 5% chance to leech 8% of the damage we deal as HP, and a 1% chance to leech 4% of the damage we deal as SP. Leeching basically just means you recover HP or SP based on the damage you deal to an enemy. You can leave Rideward hat at plus 0 for the effects we want. At plus 9, it doubles the amount of HP and SP recovered, but is not very important. Nova RO has a custom quest to craft a Rideward hat. The quest is doable by new players around level 100 and doesn't require much gear-wise. I'll leave a wiki link in the comments and description for the quest. For our armor, we will use a plus 4 Illusion Armor A. This gives us a nice attack bonus and combos with the other illusion gear that we will wear. Note that you must be level 130 in order to wear illusion equipment. You can also use a lava leather armor or a lava leather suit for plus 100 attack at level 100. For the weapon, we will use a Thanatos Katar. This is a very strong early game weapon for Rolling Cutter that has a chance to leech HP and SP when you deal damage to enemies. You can create a Thanatos Katar with gray shards from the Ghost Palace instance. I recommend doing the instance once, then buying enough gray shards to reach 200. Then trade them in for a Thanatos Katar at the Dimension Wander NPC outside of the instance entrance. If you want extra HP leeching, you can put a Hunterfly card into the Katar. This gives an additional 3% chance to restore an additional 15% of the damage you deal as HP. For the Mantu, we will use an Illusion Engine Wing B. You may notice that we are using the B Wing and not the A Wing. This is because the B Wing gives us 10% after cast delay reduction when comboed with Armor A. Slot the Mantu with a Raedric card for some early resistance. For the footgear, you can use Airship Boots when you reach level 125. These will give a nice boost in attack speed, and later you can work on getting Illusion Leg A instead. Another option is to use Lava Leather Boots for 2% attack at level 100. For the accessories, we will use two expert rings for another 10% aftercast delay reduction in total. And last, get yourself an incubus pet for some super good SP leeching. That's all we need for the early game gears. But we have some special consumables we can use to enhance our damage. Poison bottles and new poisons. Poison bottles are used by the Enchant Deadly Poison skill, and it greatly enhances your damage. And new poison refers to a list of different consumables that you can create. They grant various effects, but the one we want to use on Rolling Cutter is Magic Mushroom, which gives us a 10% after cast delay reduction. Now onto the mid-game gears. For the headgear, we can keep using a +4 Rideward hat. The leech effect that this provides is incredibly useful even at this point. For a damage headgear option, you could use one of the Endeavor Token Shop hats, like Rough Officer, for some extra attack. In the middle headgear, New Wave Sunglasses is super nice. This gives us an easy 10% after cast delay reduction. There is also a custom headgear quest to craft this item. Do not worry too much about a lower headgear, but if you are to use one, Well-Chewed Pencil is nice for more hit. A much more expensive option would be a Bloodsucker, for even more HP leeching effects. For the armor, we will use a +9 Illusion Armor A. In this, we will put two power modules and one delay after skill module. This will give us 15% after cast delay reduction and a ton of attack and attack percent. Slot this with a contaminated Raedric card for the combo. For the weapon, use a +9 Ripper Cross. The reason we get a +9 is because that's when the weapon unlocks a +30% Rolling Cutter damage bonus. The enchants on this item don't matter too much, but Fighting Spirit is the best for Rolling Cutter damage. As for the cards, two Contaminated Wanderer are best, though you can replace one of them with a Hunterfly card for extra HP leeching instead. In the garment, we will use an Illusion Engine Wing B. We keep this for the combo effect. As for the enchantments, one above all module is fine. The other two enchants can be fast for attack speed, or you can get critical modules if you plan on moving to the cross impact build later on. Slot this with a Raedric card to complete the Raedric combo. For the footgear, use Illusion Leg A. This not only gives us 5% attack when comboed with Armor A, but the Overpower enchant gives us a huge damage increase by granting us a 5% chance to gain +15% attack and +50 strength for 10 seconds. So we will have one Overpower enchant and two Vital enchants for extra tankiness. As for the card, Deep Sea Merman or Iphodes are both nice for more damage. In the left accessory, we will use a King Smith's Strong Insignia. Even though we aren't using the combo with Temporal Boots, this is still the strongest accessory in this slot. We do not care about the final enchant, so just aim for Fighting Spirit and Strength enchants. In this, we will use a Shotgun Buffalo Bandit card. In the right accessory, we will use an Illusion Booster R. We can enchant this with two Strength modules for a little bit of damage, and a Drain Life module for even more HP leeching. Slot this accessory with a Revolver Buffalo Bandit card to complete the combo. For the pet, keep using Incubus. That's all I've got for the early to mid-game Rolling Cutter build. If you have further questions, I would recommend asking inside the Thief Class channel on the NovaRO Discord server. And if this video helped you, subscribe to the channel, share this video with friends, and I'll see you in the next video.